It's happening to other people all over the world. I'm seeing everyone struggle. Almost every gay person is going through that struggle. That's why you see people talk about, you meet a gay person if you're gay, and they tell you, did you come out to your parents? How was your coming out story? And it's not actually like, let's bond over drinks, you know, like coming out stories. Yeah, guys, let's talk about. No, it's because they know how hard it must have been to do. And that's why they ask, because it's a hurdle that you have to pass. And they just talk about, like, how was it for you? And you know, someone says, yeah, so my dad kicked me out when I was 12 years old, and I lived in a children's home since then. And it's not funny. I don't know why anyone would want to live in a children's home just because they told their parents. And why do you think people come out even in their 20s, in their 30s, in their 40s? There's this writer. I don't know if you guys know the writer who wrote How to Write About Africa. And he wrote, he's a Kenyan writer. I forget his name. But if you search How to Write About Africa, you'll see him. He wrote a tribute after his mom died. And he was talking about how it broke his heart to never have told his mom that he was gay. And he was like 50 years old when he did that. Like, just go search it right now, How to Write About Africa. And he wrote, I think the story he wrote about his coming out is called something like, I think A Conversation with My Mom or something. So he was living abroad, and he said, today I got the news that my mom was dead. And he wrote it like he went to the hospital to see his mom before the mom
His
died.
name
And yeah,
Biavanga
absolutely. Like, why would you think Biavanga, an acclaimed writer, would wait until his 50s to wait for his mother to die to write that article? Because he was just like, you know what, let me experiment. You know, it's not that simple. It's not that simple. And I know there's nothing that I can say to convince everyone here to be like, yeah, you know what, gayism is okay. I know that's an unrealistic goal. But I also know that we can be politer. We can be nicer with things we don't understand. Before you tell someone like there's something wrong with you, imagine what they're going through. Imagine what their struggle is. Imagine, like, put yourself in their shoes for a minute. And if you feel like you can't be compassionate, just fuck your wife. Fuck your husband in your house by yourself. I don't know why you're spending so much time imagining other people fucking in their houses. Like, if it appalls you so badly, why do you have the time to think about it? Actually, me, maze, I can't imagine. Imagine a man's dick, maze. It's you entering another person's anus. Like, I can't. Why are you imagining it if it bothers you so much? Let's start there. Why is it bothering you so much, and yet you're spending all this time imagining it? And just because people are kissing on TV, you wherever, they're not here at me, as I can see two gay people holding hands. My kids will want to do that. Why are you? I mean, like, I think I could talk about this forever, because it's a topic that really pisses me the fuck off. Like, it pisses me off. You know, just do you. And if you can't, focus on your wife's vagina. It's not that hard. Focus on it. Every time you get home, you'll be like, yo, I need to see it to confirm that I'm straight. Like, open your legs. Let me look at that shit. You know, so I can forget all the gay people that do it. If that's what it takes for you, do it. Look at it every day. Take photos of it on your phone. The moment you see gay people talking, open those photos. Be like, this is why I'm straight. Do whatever it takes. But, like, just give other people a fucking break. They're already going through so much. They don't need your judgment on top of it. They don't need your drama on top of that. Your struggles with your sexuality. Maybe someone, I remember, okay, not in this space, but I remember someone was talking about sex and exploring anal sex for men, like, you know, just get dirty, you know, try anal stuff. And people are like, oh, never touch my butt. You know, mimi personally, I had the next morning, nilishika haga yake. I am not kidding. That man slapped me. We broke up that day. Like, ile hot three slaps, ile, bah, 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 and it was over. And I was just living there, like, nikitembea hiyo barabara nikienda kwetu tu, thinking, my God, what the fuck was that? So if you are that guy, tell your
Hello. Umesema kidogo wapi unataka kuingiza mkono ndani ya matako.
Bloom,
But
bloom, bloom.
that's where kwa matako ndio G-spot ya, that's where the G-spot of the men is
Wenye
in your ass.
G-spot.
Yes,
Bloom.
but yes, it's there.
I've spoken so much, so I'll let other people talk, but I just wanted to say it's not a choice. It's not that simple. The way everyone is saying, like, oh, at you wake up, it's a choice. It's not a choice for everyone. If it was a choice for some of us to experiment, then that's good. But for other people, it's not that you like dip your toes in the pool and just like be like, yeah, that was good, but I'm out. It's not that simple. It's not that simple. And I think the consequences that these people suffer, they would not do it if they had the choice to come out. They would not be dying. They would not be leaving their families. They would not be doing this. So just because it's not what happened to you, it's not the choice you had. And, you know, that's okay. But you don't get to sit there and make...
Your message is home.
Let me say something. Before you do anything, please learn a little bit of anatomy. You will know. Nyinyi wa baba, your G-spot is in your ass. Your prostate.
Okay, correct.
Right? Please read about that.
Bloom. Hi, Bloom.
Hi.
Okay, I just need to say something. Thank you so much for that. It was so deep. It was outlined and it was hard.